to my channel, or welcome if this is your first time coming across my channel. This channel is focused on my weight loss journey, on my journey to slim thick. I show what I eat in a day, what I eat in a week, and also weight loss experiments along the way. I also show a little bit of home and family life. So if that's something that might interest you, definitely consider subscribing. Okay, so as some of you know, I did try a low carb 30-day challenge maybe about a month or so ago. And since then, I've been kind of trying to figure out what I want to do next. I did try alternate day fasting and was trying to kind of ease my way into that. But I tried it a couple weeks ago and it didn't work out for me. So I don't know if I'm going to try it again soon. But in the meantime, I am returning back to calorie counting and having some low carb days here and there as I was doing before, and maybe even some low carb weeks. So we'll see. It just depends on what works best for me. However, when I went into my FitnessPal, the app that I use to track like my carbs and my calories, when I updated my weight to show that I lost, I think it was like 13.8 pounds or 15 pounds, whatever it was, when I put my new weight in and that I also wanted to switch from tracking carbs to tracking calories, it gave me a new calorie count that I haven't had before, which was about 1800 calories. So I thought, why not try to see what an 1800 calorie week would look like and show you guys. So that is what we will be doing this week. This video is also in partnership with MyFitnessPal. I'll let you know a little bit more about them later. But for right now, let's go ahead and get into what I eat in a week, 1800 calories a day.
Perfect.
Hey loves. Okay, you guys, so the time now is 4:52 and I'm just having my first meal. I had a really busy day today. So when I did get hungry, I had a smoothie, and yeah, this will be my first meal. So again, for this week, I will be counting my calories. And when I'm tracking my calories or tracking my carbs, I love to use my FitnessPal. Y'all, it's my favorite app for food tracking. So here I already added the smoothie that I had earlier. The calories is pretty much the same, and all of the like macros for it is pretty much the same as the tropical one. So I just used the one that I already had in there, which was the strawberry one. And as far as my lunch, as far as this, I already had the meal in there as well because I've logged it before. And then I just went ahead and added a carb counter for Tia. And my goal for losing 2 pounds a week is about 1800 calories. So what I've ate so far is about 665 calories. So yes, you guys, this is what I'll be eating. And again, I love MyFitnessPal to help me stay on track. Now, if this is your first time hearing of MyFitnessPal, here is a little bit more about them. MyFitnessPal is a fitness app with a personalized approach to fitness that doesn't believe in one size fits all. They're all about giving you the tools and knowledge that you need to be successful on your personal health journey. MyFitnessPal is a comprehensive nutrition and fitness tracker. They make it easy to track and log your foods and exercises, water intake, save meals and recipes, and you can even use their quick tools and scan barcodes to make logging your food that much easier. And with over 14 million foods in the MyFitnessPal database, it makes it easy for you to find your favorite foods, from the foods in your fridge to a night out at your favorite restaurant. Most people think that MyFitnessPal is just about counting calories, but it's so much more than that. With their premium membership, you get access to customizable tools and expert advice. It's like having a nutritionist, a trainer, and coach all in one. The premium experience also helps members learn how to improve their personal health habits. Like for me, having these deeper nutritional insights and being able to see the breakdown and summary of my macros helps me to see where I might need to scale back, like with saturated fats. None of us are perfect, but the more that I use MyFitnessPal, the more that I see what I'm putting in my body and how I can make better choices as I continue my journey. As all of you know, I like to try new things, and about a month month or two ago, I was doing a low carb challenge, and now I'm currently counting calories. With the premium membership, I can customize my dashboard to what I'm currently doing at that time of my life. And I love that. I love the fact that whether I'm counting calories, doing low carb, tracking macros, or both, I can use MyFitnessPal to help me reach my goals. I also love the MyFitnessPal community. I love chatting with members with shared goals and experiences to help support me in my journey. That extra support and encouragement is everything for me. So I definitely recommend for you guys to check out MyFitnessPal. Click on the link below to get 1 month of MyFitnessPal Premium for free. Again, go to the link in my description to get 1 month of MyFitnessPal Premium for free. So yes, you guys, that is MyFitnessPal. I definitely recommend for you to check them out. I will be sure to have all of their information in the description box below for you guys. And yes, you guys, this will be my first meal. Okay, you guys, so that was really, really good. I'm about to have me a little bit of a dessert, but I did add a second tortilla on there. So, I mean, I did eat an extra tortilla, so I'm just gonna go ahead and change that from one serving to two. Okay, so that's 90 calories. So that changed my lunch to 590 calories. And now I'm gonna have one of these no sugar added original fudge pops. And let's go ahead and add this in the app. One thing that I do like is that I can add the food by the barcode and just makes everything easier for me. So this is the barcode. We're gonna go ahead and go into my lunch, add food, and do scan barcode and then scan it. Okay, so this is the serving size for three pops, is 120 calories. So we are gonna change this to a serving size of one pop, and then that's 40 calories in 9 net carbs. So let's add that. Okay, so we have our lunch at 630 calories, and then our breakfast 120 calories. I still have 1,000 calories remaining for my dinner meal and if I decide to have dessert. So yes, you guys, I'll come back for dinner. So this is my finished dinner, and it is looking quite delicious if I do say so myself. So this is a meal that I made from a meal kit that I have. So this is 810 calories per serving. So I went ahead and did a quick add and added 810 calories under my dinner. So you can also do that as well if you don't know all of the information on it. I could plug this in later and find out everything online, but just for right now, so that I know how many calories I've used, I just went ahead and plugged it in as a quick add. So as of right now, I have used 1560 calories and I have 279 remaining. So yes, you guys, this is my dinner. Let me go ahead and give this a little taste test. Okay, so let's go ahead, and this is pork meatloaf. Normally it's beef, so let's see how this tastes. Super good, a lot of flavor. Y'all, I'm about to tear it up. I am about to tear this up. Sorry if I'm smacking, but super, super delicious, very good, and I'm about to tear it down. So yes, you guys, this is my dinner. Okay, guys, so dinner was delish, amazing. So now it is time for my dessert. I'm just gonna go ahead and end the night with 3 Oreo cookies and a glass of 2% milk. Now, I didn't eat my entire dinner. I did leave some of the slaw, but I still kept the whole 810 calories. So with logging in my Oreos and milk, I am 1 calorie over. But I think technically I should still be within my calories because I didn't eat my full dinner. I probably ate most of it. I ate the meat, the potatoes, and then a good portion of the slaw, but I didn't eat the whole thing. So yes, you guys, I'm 1 calorie over. I'm gonna go ahead and complete my diary for the day. So yes, you guys, this is how I'll be ending day 1. Loves, happy Friday. Today is Friday, and on these days we typically like to try to go somewhere and eat. So I'm thinking we're gonna do Jamaican food. They love to have some Jamaican food on Friday or Saturday, so we're gonna go to this place that's close to us. And it's already like 2:30, so I'm trying to kind of pace myself and not eat until I'm ready to eat, because that plate normally lasts me all day, and thinking I'm probably going to use most of my calories for that plate. So we shall see. But yeah, I'm probably going to kind of do more like an OMAD type of thing and, you know, use all my calories for what I really want to eat today, which is probably going to be some oxtails, rice and peas, and festival, bro. I can't go without the festival. So yes, you guys, that's what we're on our way to now. Just want to let you guys know. Okay, guys, so we just returned back home, and this is my plate of oxtails. Oh my gosh, it looks so delicious. So the time now is about 4:30. And yeah, you guys, this is what I will be having today. So again, this will probably be kind of like an OMAD day. And then I'll come back once I figured out how many calories I estimate this to be through, you know, my FitnessPal and stuff. So yes, you guys, this is what I'll be having. Loves, happy Saturday. So last night I did not get a chance to show you my ending, my calories. So this morning I went ahead and tried to find everything that I ate and just tried to be generous with it, because I know that that was a pretty good sized plate, and I estimated it in my mind to be at least like 1500 calories. So here I have Jamaican oxtail, I have rice and peas, and then I also have dumplings. So the 4 that you saw on my plate, that I had all of that, okay? I ate half of it for like lunch when I first got back, and then I ate the other half for dinner. So yeah, you guys, this is what I'm estimating it to be. And I love the fact that my FitnessPal has these type of foods to log, like Jamaican oxtails, rice and peas, dumpling, all of that is in the app. I am so happy about that. So yes, you guys, that's today. Right now you just saw me put some shrimp in the air fryer. I'm pretty hungry, so I just wanted to do something very quick. I'm gonna make a side Asian salad to go with it. I just want to show you guys what I logged for last night. Hey guys, so this is what I'll be having for my first meal. This is about a dozen shrimp and then an Asian side salad with wonton strips. This works out to be about 542 calories. I have 12 shrimp, but the way that it registered on my FitnessPal is it's 14, but the calories and everything is still the same. So 420 calories for that, the wonton strips and the dressing. And then I just put 1 cup of lettuce, because the way that it was registering on on the kit was with the dressing and all that together combined with it. So yes, you guys, works out to be a little over 500 calories. And yes, this is what I will be having for my first meal. Okay, you guys, so it's a few minutes to 7. It's about 6:57 right now, and I am about to have my dinner. I made 3 salmon croquettes, low carb salmon croquettes, and a side salad. So instead of using breadcrumbs, I used barbecue pork rinds. I know barbecue, but it does not taste like barbecue. It just has like a little bit more seasoning, a little more flavor. I have made this before on the channel, so I'll go ahead and insert a clip here so you can see how I made these. So yes, you guys, that is how these are made. On the other video, they were a little bit browner than this. I've realized over time in making these to cook them on low because they do brown pretty fast. But when I say that these are delicious, especially if you're low carb or keto, they are super, super delicious. Definitely give them a try, and they're quick and easy to make. So yes, you guys, here is my dinner. Oh, and just really quick, I did make a homemade tartar sauce. I just used 2 tablespoons of mayo and 2 tablespoons of sweet relish to make this. If you want to do it more keto or more low carb, you can use regular dill relish and then just add like some sugar-free sweetener in it to get it to your liking. So yes, you guys, this is my dinner. Hey, you guys, happy Monday. Happy Monday, y'all. Okay, so see what had happened was yesterday we went to church. Yesterday was actually a beautiful day from the beginning to the end. I had a really, really nice time yesterday. And we went to church, had a good message and all of that. And then, you know, the drill when you go out to, you go to church afterwards, most people go and get something to eat and, you know, have some little family time. And that's exactly what we did. So we went to Chili's. Now, could I have made better choices at Chili's? Yes, I could have. They did have like a guiltless menu and all that stuff. But y'all, I don't know. Now I think I know what it is. Cause this morning, Auntie Flo was here and yeah, so I just was not feeling it. I was like, I'm gonna get what I wanna get. So I ended up getting a triple dipper, like platter plate, and that's what I normally get all the time. So what I ordered was the triple dipper, like appetizer plate, or I don't know what it's called, but it's like a platter plate. And I got the Southwest egg rolls, the big mouth bites, and the chicken crispers. Oh, and I got a drink, the El Nino margarita, and that came up to 2,470 calories. So yeah, I definitely went over my calories yesterday. One thing I didn't do was eat both of my big mouth bites. I ate one. Matter of fact, let me go ahead and change it. You know, so the serving size, I'm going to change to 0.5, and then okay, so that knocked off 390 calories. So I went over about 241 calories, which isn't too bad to have exactly what I want, because that is the only thing that I ate for the day. So yeah, you guys, basically I kind of had what I wanted, but tried not to overdo it too bad. So yes, you guys, that brings us to today. And today I'm going to try to keep it light, but y'all, I've been having like just a craving for something sweet and salty. So I asked Babe to go get me some of these. Let me show you. So I asked him to get me some of these. They're popcorners and they're sweet and salty at the same time. I really, really love the taste of these. They're never fried and they are 130 calories per serving. The time now is probably going on 4 p.m. and this will be my first thing that I'll be eating. So again, I'm trying to make a little bit of healthier choices today because I know that I kind of, you know, ate more than I intended yesterday. So yeah, I'm just gonna snack on a little bit of these, probably no more than two servings. So I'm gonna go ahead and add that in my app now and then try to figure out what I'm gonna have for dinner. But yes, you guys, I just want to come in and show you what I had yesterday and just talk about it because I really didn't talk that much on camera yesterday. But yes, you guys, this is what I'll be having for my snack. So y'all, it is 8:40 right now and I don't know why I waited this long to eat, but long story short, I had a bunch of work, then I took a full nap and woke up and cleaned the kitchen, and then now I'm just now making me something. I was gonna go get something, but I was like, you know what, I don't wanna eat out again. So I just looked all in the fridge. I had nothing unthawed and decided to do a breakfast sandwich. I had eggs, bacon, bread, and cheese. So that is what I'll be doing. But while my bacon is cooking, I decided to start putting my meal into my fitness pal. And y'all, why is this sandwich about to be 950 calories? And this is what I like about my fitness pal. I feel like it's psychologically like, you putting in, because like typically you might just be like, oh, I had a breakfast sandwich, you know, like thinking like, oh, that's nothing, like that's all I had for dinner. But really, that's like, I might as well have got a whole combo, because when I really think about it, I had four pieces of bacon, which I don't know if I, maybe I should have just did like two or something, I don't know. Two eggs, two slices of cheese, mayo, and then butter and stuff like for the eggs. And y'all, I said 950 calories. I mean, the only thing that's saving me right now is that this is pretty much all that I had, with the exception of the chips that I showed you earlier. And then I did have a cactus cooler, y'all. So that by itself was almost 500 calories. And then the sandwich, that's pretty much everything. And that's 1,440 calories for the day. I mean, I'm still below my calories and that's cool. I still have 399 calories left, but I was just still wowed by this, you know? So I do like logging my things because then it helps me realize like, okay, the substitutions that I can make in the future to make healthier choices or a little bit less calories or a little bit less carbs and things of that sort. I don't have my low carb bread, so that's why I'm not using it. But typically I would just use that because it tastes like regular bread to me, the kind that I use. So yes, you guys, I'm waiting on my bacon right now and then we're just gonna go ahead and get this sandwich assembled. I am excited because I love a good breakfast sandwich, y'all. Breakfast is, I love breakfast and I haven't had breakfast for dinner in a while. Okay, you guys, so here is my finished breakfast sandwich. It is looking quite delicious. And now that I'm looking at it, I can see where the calories is coming from. Y'all, I can see where it's coming from because this sandwich looks delicious, okay? Looks like any one of your, you know, gourmet sandwiches that you might go out and purchase elsewhere, okay? We got the crispy bacon, we have two over medium eggs, cheese, and a nice thick slice of bread. So I'm glad that I did have the calories to have this. I haven't had like a, I guess you say, regular breakfast sandwich in so long. I mean, I've had a low carb version, but I haven't had a regular one in a really long time. So this is definitely a treat. And I love the fact that it is still within the calories that I'm going for today. So yes, you guys, this is what I'll be having for dinner. Part of a bedroom makeover. Okay, you guys, happy Tuesday. And yeah, don't even ask me what time it is, because sis, I've been so bad with filming today, like very bad. I ended up doing a lot of my son's room makeover today. I did put like little snippets of that. I will be showing you guys snippets along the way, but I got a lot of stuff done today with that and just had a really busy day and really didn't film a lot of what I did today, or ate for that matter. So today I will either do a screenshot or something of what I had earlier. I did have a piece of Popeye's chicken, one breast, and then I can't remember, but I didn't have much. So now I'm gonna be making a late dinner. I didn't want to make a late dinner, but that's what's happening right now. So I'm gonna have kind of like a little Asian flair type of dinner. I'm going to be making these Asian Kitchen Ling Ling pot stickers. These are our chicken and vegetable dumplings. And then I'm probably gonna pair it with some broccoli florets and then try this Rice-A-Roni stir fried rice out for the first time. Typically I'll make my own fried rice, but I saw this and babe really likes fried rice. So I think I'm gonna make two boxes just so that he can have some to eat, because I don't know if he'll eat this. So I know he'll eat rice regardless. Pretty much any kind of rice he'll eat. So I'm gonna go ahead and try to whip this up really quickly. And yeah, this will be my dinner. Okay, you guys, so this is my finished dinner. We have five pot stickers, steamed broccoli, and then our Rice-A-Roni, our fried Rice-A-Roni. Yeah, so once I made it, I was like, wait, Rice-A-Roni isn't just rice. Why do I think it was just pure rice? So it also has like these little noodles in there as well. So it's like a rice noodle mix. And I was like today years old when I realized that. I'm like, wait a minute, what's this extra stuff? I haven't had Rice-A-Roni in so many years that, yeah, it doesn't surprise me that I don't remember. But yes, you guys, this meal worked out to be about 625 calories. I will add probably a screenshot here so you can see everything that I added in here. Now, I did add 4 tablespoons of butter to make the Rice-A-Roni, but I just counted about a tablespoon of, you know, pretty much what I used out of it. There's still a ton of Rice-A-Roni left. Yeah, you guys, that's pretty much it. Now, as far as earlier, I started like racking my brain, like, what did I have? So yeah, y'all know Auntie Flo was here. I had a full sweet tooth, so I had a milkshake, but it was a glorified milkshake. So I just tried to find some calories that I thought would be sufficient, which I'm guesstimating was about 700 calories, okay? So I had that, and then I had one chicken breast, and that's what I had earlier today, and then this. So yeah, you guys, I mean, I still was able to stay within the 1800 calories for today, which I'm very happy about, and I feel like I will be satisfied with this serving as well. So yes, you guys, I had some ups and downs this week, but to me, you know, I like looking at these type of videos because I feel like it's realistic, okay? It's realistic. You're gonna have ups and downs. This week I'm not gonna weigh myself, of course, because of Auntie Flo, but yeah, we're just gonna go ahead and keep trucking along, okay? Some weeks are going to be better than others, and I'm just glad that I'm realizing that and not beating myself up, and just continue to try to be better as each week goes along. So yes, you guys, this is what I'll be having for dinner.
So yes, you guys, that concludes my video. I hope that you enjoyed it as much as I enjoyed filming it for you. And if you did, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. Make sure you guys check out my Fitness Pal in the description box below. And until my next video, have a blessed day, have a blessed week, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.